friends, welcome to the Tripoli Lovers. Today we are going to discuss DC generator classification. Whereas DC generator was classified into two types. First thing, permanent magnet DC generator and electromagnetic DC generator. Electromagnetic DC generator are classified into two types. First thing, separately excited DC generator, self-excited DC generator. Self-excited DC generator is classified into three categories. First thing, DC shunt generator and DC series generator, DC compound generator. The DC compound generator is classified into two types. First thing, DC long shunt generator, DC short shunt generator. Here you can see that the permanent magnet of DC generator, so that in this type of DC generator the flux is produced by U-shaped permanent magnet. This is called the permanent magnet as shown in the figure. The permanent magnet are fixed to the yoke. The permanent magnet is permanently fixed to the yoke. The armature is rotated. Here is the armature. It will be rotated by the means of prime mover in the magnetic field. Prime mover in the magnetic fields, these are mainly used to small generators. Permanent magnet generators are used in the small generators. Here, particularly for type of permanent magnets are used produces in the case of gas, oil and petrol engineers, and also used as a dynamo of motorcycles. By using the electromagnetic DC generator classified into separately excited DC generator and the self-excited DC generator. Whereas here in this diagram, we can clearly see that the separately excited DC generator means in this type of generators, the field magnets are excited from the independent external source. By using the DC supply, here given a battery as shown in the figure, the field winding consists of several hundred of turns. This is the turns, hundred of turns of any fine wire, and the field current can be varied by varying the resistance. By varying the resistance, there is any variable rheostat will be this, like by varying the rheostat, the resistance will be varied, connected in series with a battery. This is the battery, so that the field winding generates the flux. The EMF generated by this winding. Self-excited is classified into three categories: DC series generator, DC shunt generator, DC compound generator. DC series generator is the field winding are connected in series with the armature, so as shown in the figure. Hence the field current flows through the armature. The field current flows through the armature and the series winding. This series winding, since the series field winding carries a full load current, this series winding carries a full load current. It is designed with a few tons of thick wire. Due to the large cross section area of field winding, the resistance of series field winding will be very low, 0.5%, less than 0.5%. So that whereas I is equal to amp armature current, here is equal to armature current IA, it is the IA we carries IA armature current. RSC, ISC means it is a series field current, and IL, it is a load current, it is an a load current, and RA means it is armature resistance. RSC means it is a series field ohm, series field resistance in ohms, voltage, terminal voltage in volts. Whereas an EG is equal to, it is an EG, EB or EG is a EMF generated in volts. Here the EG is equal to V plus voltage generated V plus IA RA plus ISC RAC, where IA and ISC are same equal to each other to equal to load voltage, load current, sorry. Here EG is equal to V plus IA, we are common the IA, so that IA RA plus RAC holds. The next thing is DC shunt generator. Whereas in DC shunt generator, the field winding is connected across parallel with an armature. Here the armature is connected across the series generator. So as shown in the figure, the current flowing through the shunt field winding is about 5% rated armature current. Hence the shunt field winding will be designed with many tons of wire. These therefore the resistance of the shunt field winding high of an order of 100 ohms. The voltage across the shunt field is same as the terminal voltage of the generator, so that here EG is equal to EMF generator EG is equal to V plus IA RA. So the compound generator was classified into two types: DC long shunt generator, DC short shunt generator. Whereas DC long shunt generator, here in the long shunt generator, the shunt field winding is connected across both the shunt field winding is across connected both the armature and series field winding. This is the series field winding, this is the shunt field winding. They are connected across both armature as shown in the figure. It by connecting the field across armature and series field, hence it is known as a long shunt compound generator. The voltage across the shunt field winding is equal to the terminal voltage. This is the terminal voltage, is equal to terminal voltage. Here the armature current IA and series field current is equal to, both are equal. The shunt field current is equal to ISH is equal to V by RSH, whereas IA is equal to IL plus ISH, so that VG is equal to V plus, where EG means it is an EMF generated by the armature. V is equal to IA RA minus ISC RSC. This is the final EMF equation. Whereas in the DC short shunt generator, in this the shunt field is connected across the armature terminal. It is the shunt field is connected across the armature terminal, and it requires a long shunt wire are connected shunt field across the armature. Hence it is known as short shunt DC compound generator. The voltage across the shunt field is some what we more the terminal voltage. Here the V is equal to V plus ISC RSC, and ISC is equal to IL, and ISH is equal to V by RSH, IA is equal to IL plus ISC. Here EG is equal to V plus IA RA plus ISC RSC. Here finally, from the first equation, both V plus ISC plus RSC, here we notice that V, so that V plus IA RA, this is the final equation, EG is equal to, for the short shunt compound generator. Thank you friends, please like and subscribe to my channel.
Do you have any doubts? Please comment below. Please subscribe and share the video to your friends. Thank you for watching this video.